Hi everyone, warm welcome to my channel. I am Manu V. Today I am going to discuss another important topic, that is Sargent Florence theory of industrial location. Sargent Florence, a critic of Alfred Weber's theory of location, has developed an entirely different approach to industrial location. He has followed the inductive method in formulating his theory of location. This technique is more reliable and accurate in calculating the degree of variation of dispersal and concentration of industries. He started with the idea that some of Weber's assumptions are not realistic. Sargent Florence's theory of industrial location states that the relation of the industry to the distribution of occupied population is more important than the relation between industry and area. His main consideration is that occupational distribution of population should be the main and primary factor for taking into consideration the location of an industry. Florence has worked out statistical measures of the degree of localization of different industrialization from the census of production. He has introduced two new concepts in the glossary of the theory of industrial location. First factor, location factor. Second, coefficient of localization. First, location factor. Location factor is an index of the degree of concentration of an industry in a particular place. Location factor refers to the percentage of all workers in a particular industry found in a certain region to the percentage of all workers in that industry. It can be calculated by any of these methods. By dividing total industrial population of a place by total industrial population of the country. By dividing total industrial population of the locality in the industry concerned by total industrial population of the country in the same industry concerned. It is the ratio of two ratios. They are number of workers engaged in a particular industry of an area divided by total number of workers engaged in all industries in the area into 100. Total number of workers engaged in all industry with the area divided by total number of industries workers in the country into 100. Or percentage of workers engaged in a particular industry divided by proportion of total number of workers engaged in the area to the total industrial workers of the country. If the location factor index is equal to 1, industry is located on the whole country. Because the proportion of the total industrial workers of the region would be equal to the proportion of the workers in a particular industry. If an industry is not evenly distributed over the whole country, the location factor would either be more than unity or less than unity. If the location factor index is greater than 1, there is a tendency of centralization. If the location factor index is less than 1, there is a tendency of decentralization. Suppose that population of industrial workers in a country is 500. Workers engaged in a given area is 200. And workers engaged in a particular industry are 100. The location factor index will be the 100 into 100 divided by 200 whole divided by 200 by 500 into 100, or 50 divided by 40, that is equal to 1.25. Here the index is greater than 1, therefore the industry appears to be centralized in that area. Next, coefficient of localization. The coefficient of localization indicates the propensity of an industry to concentrate. That means an industry's tendency for localization anywhere in the country. It is primarily concerned with a particular industry and not a particular region. Coefficient of localization can be found with the help of following formula. Percentage of all workers found in each region. Percentage of the workers of industry in each regions. And positive deviations of B from A are to be added. And sum thus derived is to be divided by 100. Result will be coefficient of localization. That is, percentage of workers in the area minus percentage of workers in particular industry divided by 100. If this coefficient is 0, it will mean that industries are evenly distributed all over the areas. If the coefficient is unity, it indicates concentration of industries in one area. The coefficient being greater or less than unity will indicate tendency of centralization or decentralization respectively. Suppose the percentage of workers in the area is 90 and those engaged in a particular industry is 60. The coefficient will be 90 minus 60 divided by 100. That is 30 divided by 100 is equal to 0.3. Since the coefficient of localization is less than unity, industries have a tendency of decentralization in that area. The object of arriving at such an index is to classify industries according to their qualities of dispersion or concentration. On the basis of the coefficient of localization, all industries can be divided into 3 degrees: high coefficient industries, medium coefficient industries, and low coefficient industries. Industries with a high coefficient of localization, like mining industries, are centralized at particular regions. Conversely, industries with a low coefficient of localization, such as leather work, brick making, building, etc., can develop in different regions and are thus dispersed. In between are such industries as textiles, jute, paper, cement, etc., which have a wide choice of location. It has been observed that industries situated near the source of raw material have lesser tendency to disperse, that is, high coefficient industries, whereas industries located away from the sources of raw materials possess greater tendency to disperse, that is, low coefficient industries. Finally, critical appraisal. The two statistical indices prepared by Sargent Florence are of immense significance for studying the location dynamics in any country. However, Florence's inductive approach has also invited criticism. Important points of criticism are: first, ignorance of causes of location. The theory tells only whether the industry is centralized or decentralized, but does not give the causes of such a tendency. And difficulty of knowing propensity of localization. It is difficult to know only on the basis of coefficient of localization whether there is propensity of centralization or decentralization. And ignorance of favorable local conditions. The theory does not care for the favorable local factors influencing centralization of industries. And last point, absence of knowledge of productive capacity. The theory emphasizes the number of workers in calculating the index and coefficient, but ignores production. Let me conclude. However, notwithstanding certain limitations, the two statistical indices are an invaluable guide for analyzing the trends of industrial development in a country. Have a nice day. Thank you.